Hi, my name is Germán Abrevaya. I am a physics PhD student from University of Buenos Aires, and today I'm going to talk about the paper published on TMLR entitled Effective Latent Differential Equation Models via Attention and Multiple Shooting. This work is about how to incorporate prior knowledge of your system in the forms of differential equations into general machine learning models. In particular, we have been working with latent differential equation models, which you can think of as some kind of variational autoencoder with differential equations inside ruling the latent space dynamics. Specifically, we focus on a model called GOKU-nets. As in any autoencoder, here the goal is that the output reconstructs the input as close as possible. In this context, the inputs are high-dimensional time series. Initially, each time frame is processed independently, usually reducing the dimensionality. Next, they are processed sequentially in order to learn the parameters and initial conditions of a differential equation which is explicitly provided, allowing you to incorporate some prior knowledge of your system. Then the equations are solved, and lastly, the trajectories are transformed back to the original space. We apply this to brain images, in particular to resting state fMRI, using stochastic Stuart-Landau oscillators for the differential equations. The Stuart-Landau oscillators are some of the simplest nonlinear oscillators, which also have a long-standing history in modeling neural ensemble dynamics. However, for training this model, it is needed to differentiate through the solver and through the differential equations, calculate gradients with respect to the initial conditions and parameters, which tend to produce quite complex loss landscapes. And in turn, this can make the training sometimes a bit challenging. In fact, if you train a neural ODE on even on very simple oscillatory data like this, sometimes it may converge to this kind of local minima that resembles the time average of the oscillatory data. One way to overcome this is by using a method that is well established in the system identification and control fields called multiple shooting, which consists of splitting the time span into multiple windows, solving for each of them in parallel, and then trying to impose some continuity between the windows. This was already implemented for neural ODEs, but we extended it for latent state models, where you don't have access to the ground truth initial conditions, because the differential equations actually occur in the model the latent space dynamics, occurring in the latent space. But what you can try to do is to impose some continuity between the windows. So we implemented a multiple shooting training strategy in the latent space by using multiple initial conditions, but a shared set of parameters for all the windows, and then imposing continuity with the regularization term in the loss function, penalizing for the discontinuities in the latent space. In addition, we added an attention mechanism to the part of the model that inferred the parameters, which was this bidirectional STM. And to the GOKU-nets, with all of these enhancements, we call it GOKU with ubiquitous inference, or in short, GOKU-UI. Now let's see in detail the attention mechanism. But let's first recall how a traditional bidirectional LSTM works. So you have one LSTM processing your time series forward in time, another LSTM processing them backwards, and the final output is the concatenation of the last outputs from each LSTM. On the other hand, in the attentional bi-LSTM, we keep all the outputs from both LSTMs and do a linear combination of them weighted by some attentional scores. Now let's see a toy example of the multiple shooting. First, you partition your time span into shorter overlapping windows and process each of them with the same LSTM. And then their outputs will end up being the initial conditions for each of the multiple shooting windows. Then by using the single shared set of parameters derived before from the attentional bi-LSTM, you solve the equations in parallel for each of the windows, and you add a continuity constraint in the loss function, quadratically penalizing for the differences between the last point of each window and the initial point of the next one. We evaluated the models on two datasets, one synthetic and one empirical. For the synthetic one, we use three coupled stochastic Stuart-Landau oscillators with different initial conditions and parameters, while augmenting their dimensionality in order to have some high dimensional inputs which were actually sourced from some low dimensional dynamical system. On the other hand, for the empirical data, we use resting state fMRI from 153 human subjects, and in particular 11 time courses from a canonical ICA analysis, while using also 20 Stuart-Landau oscillators as the dynamical core for the GOKU-nets. Even though we train the models only for reconstruction, we also evaluated them on the forecast task, because for all of those models, you can continue integrating the equations farther in time beyond the reconstruction limit in order to generate some future activity prediction. We also compare them against a few baselines, namely LSTMs, latent ODEs, augmented neural ODEs. Also in the forecast task, we included a vector autoregressive model. And we also included a naive predictor, which was simply the time average of the input data. Let's dive into the results. This corresponds to simulated data. On the left, you'll find the reconstruction error, and on the right, the forecast error, both plotted as a function of the training set size. Notice that the axes are in logarithmic scale. Here we can see that just by adding the attention mechanism corresponding to this orange curve, it already improves the performance over the plain GOKU-net in turquoise. Training with multiple shooting, this green line, boosts the performance even farther. But the best overall performance comes from combining both enhancements, which is GOKU-UI in violet, achieving a threefold decrease in reconstruction error. It also displays a great data efficiency, reaching its peak performance with only 300 samples, while surpassing other models that had been trained with up to 16 times more data. Turning to the forecast task, with a fixed 20 steps forecast horizon, at the lowest end of the training data size, VAR achieves the best performance. It is expected that simpler statistical methods like VAR cannot shine more complex machine learning models in scenarios with scarce training data. However, as we expand our dataset beyond 150 samples, GOKU-nets trained with multiple shooting take the lead, consistent with the trend from the reconstruction task. Just for having a visual sense of the reconstructions, here we have a few examples from the Stuart-Landau test set. The orange dots show the ground truth, the turquoise curve represent the plain GOKU-net, while the violet one corresponds to GOKU-UI. It's clear from this qualitative comparison that GOKU-UI provides a reconstruction that's much more aligned with the real data points. Now let's see the results for the empirical dataset. As before, to the left we have the reconstruction error, and to the right the forecast error. In this case, we can observe that the addition of the attention mechanism didn't significantly improve the performance with respect to the plain GOKU-net. However, multiple shooting made a big difference, with GOKU-UI achieving a five-fold decrease in reconstruction error compared to the plain GOKU-net. Regarding to the forecast task, VAR initially exhibited the best accuracy for short-term predictions, but its effectiveness dropped rapidly over time. This can be attributed to the relative slowness of the fMRI signal. However, focusing on the GOKU-net models, we can see multiple shooting as a key improvement factor. While GOKU-UI started with larger prediction errors than VAR, its errors degraded slower, maintaining better performance than other models for up to 15 seconds ahead. Beyond that, all models performed quite poorly, which is understandable given the complexity of the system under study. Predicting brain activity 15 seconds ahead is not trivial at all. Again, for having a visual inspection on the reconstructions, here are some representative ICA time components from test subjects. Once more, we can see that the GOKU-UI reconstructions in violet are much closer to the actual data than the plain GOKU-nets in turquoise. Lastly, we can also assess the performance on full brain reconstructions by linearly combining the ICA spatial support components weighted by their corresponding time courses. Here we have a comparison of the average whole brain reconstruction errors for the four GOKU-net variants represented on a glass brain visualization from three different perspectives. This visualization allows us to observe the impact of the multiple shooting training strategy and gain insights into the spatial distribution of errors across the brain. Well, in summary, we have significantly enhanced GOKU-nets by adding an attention mechanism to the part of the model that learns the parameters and by developing a multiple shooting training strategy in the latent space, which uses multiple initial conditions but a shared set of parameters for all windows, and a regularization in the loss function penalizing discontinuities in the latent space. These enhancements have improved performance and data efficiency for both reconstruction and forecast tasks on simulated and empirical datasets. In the latter case, by using 20 Stuart-Landau oscillators, we were able to encode the whole brain dynamics into a latent, low-dimensional, and interpretable dynamical system. In future work, we aim to leverage this representation to gain neuroscience insights, such as inferring functional connectivity or classifying mental states or conditions. Finally, I want to thank all the amazing people around the world who have contributed to this work and to whom I am very grateful. You can scan this QR code to access the full paper, as well as the ChatGPT instance that is expert in our paper and will hopefully be able to respond to any question that you have about our work. Otherwise, don't hesitate to contact me or leave your questions in the comments of this video. And here are some references for this talk, but of course you will find many more in the paper. Thank you so much for your attention.